Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Engineering Toolbox channel. So in this one, I got a really cool trick that actually came about because a viewer of mine asked a very simple question. He said, hey, I went through and I made this chart, but what I really want is to only show the last, say, 30 days from the data set. And you can see in this example, it's already getting kind of cluttered and things are maybe a little bit too condensed, or you have to like shrink down text or whatever to make this all work. So he just wanted to have like this rolling chart that would show only the last 30 data points from the entire data set as he's adding data to it over time. And there's actually a fairly simple way to do this, dynamically in fact, so that as we're adding data, it'll update the chart to the most recent 30 days of data. And don't worry if this chart doesn't look familiar to you. This is from one of my control charting videos, but I'm just gonna focus on how do we get this chart so that it only shows the most recent 30 days. So if that's what you're looking for, definitely stick around. Don't be intimidated by this kind of crazy chart or anything like that. This will be a really simple example that'll show you exactly how to do that. With that, let's dive in. So the first thing I wanna do is I wanna take all the column headers from my original table. And for those of you who are just joining us for this video and didn't see the previous videos on this topic, I use a lot of tables. So make sure that you're using tables as you're doing this. It really helps with keeping things dynamic. So I'm going to copy and paste all the table headers, and then I'm going to insert this as a new table. So now I have my table headers, and what I want to do is actually we're going to dynamically fill in this date column based on the information in our original table. We're gonna create a dynamic formula. So what we first have to do is get the max date from this table. Now, if you don't have some kind of data in this first column that uniquely identifies each row, and what I mean by that is this is 10/9/2017, and that value is unique for this entire column. So each day or date in this data set uniquely identifies each row. So if you don't have that, what I recommend you do is add an index column. And a good way to do that dynamically is if you just add this index column, and I'll move that to the front. If you just go row minus one, this is the second row, so 2 - 1 = 1. And if I reformat this column as, let's do it as text, then we get a unique identifier for each row in this table. So my data set does uniquely identify itself just by date. So I'm just gonna use that. So if we grab the max from that date column, and I'll just reformat this, so short date. Okay, so now that we have the max date, what we can do is build a dynamic formula that'll work no matter what size this table is and all that stuff. This will all make sense in a little bit, just bear with me. So what we first wanna do is get the number of rows that are in this table. So this is table 3. So it's gonna count the number of rows, and then we're gonna subtract the current row and then subtract 1 from that. So now because there's only one row in this table, it's calculating the last data point in the main table. But watch what happens when I fill this down a few rows. So now we have the last data point in the main table, and then it just subtracts 1 for each row that's in this table. Now what's interesting is I can come in here and I can delete those out again, and it recalculates. So basically how this works is the number of rows or data points that you want to show in your chart is determined by the number of rows in this table. So if I want 30 data points in my chart, I would just fill this down 30 rows. So now that we have that, we can do a Vlookup. Since this is all set up nice for us, we just do a Vlookup, and we're gonna look up this value from table 1. Let's go hashtag all. So table 1 all, and then a column index, and check this out, we can just go column. What's the current column number? Well, we're in the second column. We want to look up the second column from the original table. So that works out nice. And then we're just going to do an exact match, hit enter. And then if we look up the last data point in that original table, it should be 74. Boom, 74. And now you can see how that formula can easily be copied throughout each column in this table, because if we go to column C, that's the third column, well, that's going to correspond to the third column that we want to look up in the original table. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy and paste this all over like that. Boom, it all fills down, and then we have our copied table. Now, I don't know that all the formatting is correct here. Everything's in a percent, but I think we should be okay. So now we have a dynamic data set that'll update as we add data. It'll show the last 30 data points always, no matter what. So if I add a data point here, and let's just make this 50, boom, 1130, 50%, and then it just counts back from there. Now it didn't add a row here, it just updated these values. So now if we want to create a chart from this, we can insert a line chart, and there we go. Now no matter what, this will always show the last 30 data points. Now just to show that we can have a dynamic chart from this, if I only want 10 data points, if I just delete 10 data points out of there, well, the chart updates. And same thing, if I want to add more data points to this, I can just fill that down and the chart updates. How cool is that? So hopefully you like this trick as much as I do. If you enjoyed, please like and share. Please consider subscribing so you don't miss any other data analysis tools like the one you just watched, plus much, much more. Everything from engineering software to data analysis, plus plenty of other engineering tools.